But you know what I can't get over? That she was taken like that, just like that. Gone.
Scott, she's not really gone. You'll never lose her because she's going to be in your heart. And she's going to live in your spirit.
Why did you write that letter when you did?
Because I was missing her. We hadn't been in contact for a long time.
You know, she would have wanted me to have helped you if you're in any kind of trouble or anything. Are you?
What you said before about feeling like she was taken away from you too soon and that you weren't ready for her death. Well, I know what that's like. My husband died the same way. We hadn't even been married a year. One minute we were together, and the next, I was alone.
I'm sorry.
This is why I didn't want to stay. I knew this would happen.
No, I think this is good. You know, we've been brought together for some reason that we don't know.
Maybe.
Well, listen. Thank you for trusting me enough and opening up and telling me what happened here. I appreciate that.
Sure.
Now, listen, before we go, I just want to do one other thing here. Dominique and I went up to Cape Cod. And the first morning she got up really early, and she shot out on the beach, and she found this shell. And she was very, very excited about it. Very excited about it. And this one I always liked, you know. She had this little collection. I don't know if she had it back when you guys were kids, but she had this hell of a shell collection, and I liked this one, so I stole it from her. But I think that they should be together back, and I wanted to leave this here for her so she knows. I love you. I miss you.
Good. Listen, could you bring me 2 pieces of plain dry wheat toast with no butter? And if you don't hurry up, I'm probably going to throw up or just faint right here on the spot. Thanks.
Feeling aces, huh?
I'm feeling disgusting.
You're, usual disgusting?
Yes, don't worry. I'm fine because I'm feeling my usual disgusting, so that must mean everything's okay.
Were you wanting to meet me, or is this a coincidence?
No coincidence.
And what's up?
I am very happy that I got a chance to talk to you before you went to New York. You can't go with Catherine.
Is jealousy another side effect of pregnancy?
I am not jealous. The fact is, Catherine Crawford is one big, fat fake.
Last night's receipts were incredible.
Good night.
That's an understatement. Must have been everyone's night to get out of the house. Look at this.
Ooh, I love it.
You gonna be finished with that soon?
No. Why?
Because we have a date this afternoon, remember?
Yes, I remember.
You gonna be able to make it?
Yes. What are we doing?
It's a surprise.
The new you?
For today, yes.
I prefer the old you better.
Well, I'm meeting with the grand jury today, and I want to feel sort of...
Nancy Reagan-ish?
No, stop. Conservative.
That's not Nancy Reagan.
Since I'm going to testify against Ryan with the grand jury, I want to feel very conservative.
Alicia, if that's what you're worried about, forget it. Jessica's got enough to put Chamberlain away for three lifetimes.
Still, though, I'm not going to take any chances. Jessica's worried about having Chan's baby, and I know that her mind is not going to be 100% on her work. You know what I mean?
Dr. Ralston, please call extension
570.
Good morning,
Amy.
Hi, Sean. Hi, Tiff.
Hi,
You know, Dr. Meadows is running a little bit late this morning.
It's okay, honey.
Oh, thanks.
Have I told you? Today.
What
a handsome, loving, sexy husband you are.
Well, if you did, I can't remember.
Well, let me remember.
Do you two know each other?
Whoops.
We got caught.
Hi, Jessica. How are you?
I thought you'd be pacing the halls of justice by now, Jessica.
No. I had an early doctor's appointment.
General Hospital, brought to you by Soft and Dry.
Is anything wrong?
Oh, no. I just had my checkup with my gynecologist.
Oh, it's always great to get that six-month checkup out of the way, isn't it?
Hey, Tiff?
Yeah.
Dr. Meadows can see you now. Thank you.
Oh, thanks, Amy. Dr. Meadows is your doctor?
Yes.
Is that who you just saw?
Mm-hmm. It's a small world, isn't it?
Oh, it is, and she's so great. You're gonna love her. Actually, I don't want to keep her waiting. I don't know why she keeps me waiting all the time. Darling, do you have time for lunch today?
Yeah, well, I could probably sneak out during the noon recess, yeah.
1 o'clock at the Outback then?
Yeah, fine. Any change, I'll give you a call. Honey.
Great. Good luck today.
Oh, we won't need any. Ryan's dug his own grave.
Oh, okay. Bye, sweetie. Mm-hmm. I'll see you later.
Yeah. So what did the doctor say? You're pregnant?
I'll know later.
When?
This afternoon.
Yeah, I still don't understand why you didn't take one of those home pregnancy tests.
Because I didn't want to, Sean. Listen, if I took one of those and the results were positive, I still would have to come and see the doctor.
Mm.
And if they were negative, I still would have to see the doctor to find out why my period was so late, okay?
Sure.
This way, I kill two birds with one stone.
Yeah, right. Oh, good morning, Steve.
Dr. Hardy?
Oh, hi.
You ready to testify?
I suppose so.
Listen, sir, don't be nervous and just tell it like it is, okay?
I will. I certainly will. How's Audrey doing, Steve? Not very good. She's still traumatized about what happened.
I'm sorry to hear that. Listen, I will do everything in my power to not have her testify, but I can't make any promises, okay? We're going to have to do anything we can to nail Ryan.
Oh, look, I'm not sure I'd allow her to testify in her present state of mind.
It's that bad?
Right now, she's afraid of her own shadow. I've never seen her this way.
Oh, damn. You know, you and Audrey shouldn't have been involved in this in the first place.
Listen, sir, are you free to come into the courtroom before noon? I hope that works with your schedule.
Just let me know when you need me. I'll be there.
Okay, thank you.
I want to know the minute you get those test results back.
Who else would I call?
Just be discreet about it.
Don't insult me, Sean. I haven't told anyone.
Keep it that way.
Whatever's going on in Jessica's life, her mind is on the hearing.
Fine. But I still don't trust her. Look what she's doing to Sean. She's stringing him along with her pregnancy. I think she's nuts.
That's a whole other issue.
No, it isn't.
Yes, it is, Felicia.
No, it isn't.
Yes, it is. We're not going to argue about it right now. Okay? Dress however you like, up or down. It'll be fine. Can I have that ball, please? Thank you.
Why didn't she just go to the doctor when she thought she was pregnant in the first place?
I don't know.
Wouldn't you?
If I were Sean or if I were Jessica?
Jessica, wouldn't you want to know so that you could make arrangements?
This is none of our business. Look, I don't even know why we're talking about it.
Because Sean is a very good friend of ours. Aren't you worried about what might happen if Jessica goes through with this pregnancy?
There is nothing I can do about it.
That's not what I said, is it? That's not what I just said. I asked if you were worried.
Why did I even tell you about this in the first place?
I figured it out all by myself.
Yeah, right.
Mac, I can't believe you.
Why? Because I don't like to gossip?
I am not gossiping.
Look, Felicia, Sean is a big boy, okay? He's a grown man. He got himself into this problem. Besides, there's nothing I can do to help him.
What if there were?
Now what are you talking about?
Nothing specific, but what if there was something you could do to help Sean out of this mess with Jessica? Would you help?
Of course I would.
Well, maybe if we just stand here and talk about it for a while, we can come up with a solution.
No, we're not going to do that, okay? I'm through debating this with you.
I don't want to debate it either. I just want to see if we can come up with some kind of solution of some sort.
You don't
want
to debate it? Excellent. Then why don't you find out if you're going to do inventory before or after the court hearing and let me know?
Sean's a lot more important than this inventory.
Felicia, we stopped talking about Sean just a few words ago.
So then what are we talking about right now?
The fundamental difference between men and women.
And what might that be?
That women like to gossip. That's what they like to do. You see, they can talk for weeks and weeks and weeks on end and never know what they're talking about. I mean, they'll end up right at the very start of what they were talking about and never know what the mindless stuff they were talking about in the middle was. You understand what I'm saying?
Do you ever read the sports page?
What does that have to do with anything?
It's half gossip. As a matter of fact, it's probably all gossip.
Felicia, you're stretching it right now.
No, I'm not. Is manager A going to be replaced by manager B, who was fired from team C because he threw the telephone at owner D? Now, that's really interesting.
What goes on behind the scenes is very, very important to the game.
Well, that's just it. That's a game. What women have to say is a lot more important.
You know, I thought you liked sports.
I do like sports. I love sports. But you know how many men come in here and talk about ERAs? I'm talking about earned run averages, not equal rights amendments. Or MVPs or RBIs or PPGs. I don't even know what a PPG is.
Points per game.
Points per game?
Yeah.
Hi.
Hi. Sorry, we're not open yet.
I know. I'm looking for Bill Eckert. Is he here?
Yeah, sure. Is he expecting you?
No, I thought I'd surprise him.
I hate surprises, Sailor. You know I've always hated surprises.
Tough.
Tough? Eckert. Now? Can it wait? All right. I'll be right there. I have been trying to get a hold of this demolitions expert. I'm trying to pull down a section of the pier, and now he's there, and now he has to see me now or no go. So I, what time do you want me?
Noon.
Your place?
Well. Thank you. You are a lifesaver.
You ready to order?
Well, I'm waiting for somebody, but I'll have some more coffee.
I really could use some milk. A big glass of skim milk. That would be wonderful. Thank you. I wonder what they make this toast out of. It's so good. It's like grainy or kind of malty thing.
Now, what is this about Catherine being a fake?
All right. Remember how Catherine told us she went to school with Dominique? That's how she knows her?
Right.
Right. Well, Mac told me Dominique didn't go to school. She was tutored at home.
Well, call the cops. Let's have her arrested.
I don't think this is funny. Scott, look, if Catherine is not an old school chum of Dominique's, then who the hell is she and what does she want with you?
Well, I'm sure there's some kind of explanation here.
An explanation or some kind of cover-up?
Now, look, Lucy, either way, she's going to lose with you, right?
No. The fact is she lied and that should bother you. Doesn't it bother you at all?
What bothers me is that...
Hi. Sorry, I'm late.
Hello.
I got hung up on a phone call. Hi, Lucy.
Hello.
It's quite all right.
What a nice surprise.
Well, she's not really staying. She just stopped in for some emergency toast, you know, the pregnancy thing.
Actually, I have quite a little bit of time. Oh, thank you. Just got me over a big hump in my day. Hmm? What's wrong? You know, morning sickness.
Oh, you know, I had a friend in New York who had that when she was pregnant. She would eat all day long. I mean, constantly.
Hmm. Oh, well, really?
Yeah, she was nibbling. That's the only way she could keep from getting sick, you know?
I hate to ask this, but did she gain a lot of weight?
A ton.
I didn't want to hear that, Scott. I really don't want to hear this.
Oh, Lucy, I wouldn't worry about that if I were you. I mean, you look great.
Thank you. I know. Now I do. But if I keep munching like this, I mean, who's... Never mind. What did your friend have? A boy or a girl?
A girl.
Oh, a girl. That's very sweet. So, Catherine, where did you say that you went to school, with Dominique?
I heard so much about the Outback, I'm glad I finally got a chance to see it.
Me too.
And I'm also glad I finally got a chance to meet the famous Mac and Felicia. You're on the evening news.
Yeah. Well, it's nice to meet you too.
Yes, very much. We heard a lot about you, your operation.
It must be so great to be able to see you again.
You can't believe it.
Victoria!
Hi.
I see you've met.
Uh-huh.
Oh, well, what a surprise. I'm just running out for breakfast. Are you hungry?
No, but you know what? I can use a cup of coffee.
Great. Let's go. Mac will go over these invoices later.
Yeah, sure. Looking forward to it.
Okay. It was nice to meet you both of you.
Goodbye.
Nice to meet you. Bye.
She seems sweet.
Don't start, Felicia.
It's pretty clear what's going on here.
Yeah, I know.
He just wanted to take her away so Holly wouldn't see her.
Look, I know, Felicia. I was here, remember? Okay, we were both here. We both know what's going on. So why do we have to talk about it?
Think about it, Mac. Poor Holly.
Poor Holly what? Where's Bill?
He
left with Victoria, didn't he? Sorry, Holly.
It's okay. I'm not in the dark anymore, believe me.
Well, if you were, I would have turned on the lights for you.
Thank you. I appreciate that.
Maybe it's not what it looks like.
It is. I thought you two would be on your way to court by now.
Yeah, we're going right now.
Are you okay?
Yes, fine.
Well, I'm going to go call in an invoice for the liquor order.
Oh, wait a minute. How are you going to know? You didn't even take inventory. How are you going to know what kind of liquor to order?
Mac, trust me. I'm a professional. You have to trust me on these things.
Look, Holly,
it is what it is, Mac.
How did you find out?
Virtually walked in on them at the lighthouse.
Great. So why are you still friendly with them?
Did I look friendly?
Well, yeah. At least I thought so.
Good. I mean, I'm furious. I'm disgusted with him, but I just don't want him to know yet.
Why? What are you planning on doing?
Nothing elaborate.
Catherine, you did say that you and Dominique went to school together, right?
Yes, I did. Well, it wasn't school, exactly. I just say that because it's easier than explaining. We were tutored at home, actually, in a little cottage on Dominique's father's estate.
Well, how about that? Did you hear that, Lucy? We're tutored.
Yeah, I definitely heard that.
That's incredible.
It really was. I mean, we probably miss out on a lot of kids' stuff, but I wouldn't trade that experience now for anything in the world.
No, I can imagine.
You know, Scott, I have this fabulous picture of me and Dominique standing in front of the schoolhouse. I'll have to dig it up for you when we get to New York.
Oh, yeah, that'd be nice. Maybe I can borrow it from you and go to Lucy, because She was very interested in both of you guys' education.
Well, I'll just get you a copy that you can keep.
You hear that, Lucy? I'm going to get my own copy.
Oh, that's fantastic. I really would love to see it. Well, I really should be going. I've got to check out the hotel.
I'll tell you what. Why don't you tell me what you want, and when you come back, it'll be here.
You know what I would love?
What?
Is the French toast. Mm. The cinnamon kind they have here. Yeah. Have you ever had that, Lucy?
Nope. Can't say that I have.
Oh, you really should. It's delicious. It's right up there on the scale of breakfast that you always want, but you never have. Well, I better get going.
Catherine.
Yes.
I'm going to have to get going myself. So I won't be seeing you again, but do take care of your ankle.
Oh, I will. Thank you. I hope I see you again sometime.
Oh, me too.
Bye.
Mm-hmm. Bye. Gosh, I gotta go spa weights.
Are you happy?
What?
What?
What? All right, so I listened to Mac's information, but Mac said that, and so I believed it. That's
well, I don't really care what Mac has to say, and I wish you would keep your nose out of my business.
You know, I was just looking out for your best interests.
Oh, please don't.
Steve, how'd it go? Well, I told him exactly what happened.
What was Ryan doing?
Mostly he kept looking over at me, knowing full well I still had the urge to kill him.
Jessica.
Yeah, Mac, everything's fine. We're on a 15-minute recess, and then I'll be ready for you, Sean.
All right. Look, I'm going to go make a phone call. I'll be right back.
Jessica, you will keep me informed as to how it goes this afternoon?
Sure, I have to put in a call to the hospital this afternoon, but I'll have them transfer me up to you.
There's no possibility that Ryan will be granted bail, is there?
None whatsoever, and you and Audrey don't have to worry about that.
Good, good, but I still want to hear when it's official.
Okay, no problem.
Steve, I'll walk you out. I'll get some fresh air anyway.
Don't be long, Sean.
I won't.
So, Felicia, nice outfit.
Are you pregnant?
Excuse me?
Now, Sean is like a father to me, and I don't appreciate what you're doing to him.
Wait a minute, back up a bit. Did Sean tell you?
I figured it out for myself.
How?
Now, Jessica, if you're so smart, how the hell did you get pregnant?
So, Catherine was telling the truth, but you wouldn't even consider the possibility for one teeny tiny moment that she wasn't.
Because I know she wasn't.
How could you know that? How do you have this instant loyalty for some woman you just met?
I don't know. I just trust her. That's all. I trust her.
Well, you shouldn't, okay? You shouldn't. You just inherited a lot of money, Scott. A lot. And people are going to be coming out of the woodwork trying to take all or part of it from you.
I'll keep my eyes open.
You're not taking this seriously at all, are you? Okay. All right, fine. Why don't you look at it this way? That money is your unborn child's future. It's her money.
Which is what this is really all about, isn't it?
What is that supposed to mean?
Well, it's about you and the baby and protecting your stake in all of this.
I don't have any stake in all this.
I thought maybe that you've changed. But what was I thinking?
Don't start with that. No, I'm not going to listen.
All you care about is you. That's all you ever care about is you.
Something. I hope you have a really nice trip.
Okay, hey, I'll tell you what, though. I'll be looking for all the fortune hunters.
Fine. Keep your eyes open.
Sudden mood swings, you know, that happens.
Yeah, well, you know, we're always fighting about something or another. Yeah, that's the way it is.
Yeah, she seems sort of suspicious of me.
Well, she would be suspicious of Santa Claus. Where's the waiter? I'm hungry, and you're hungry.
About Friday the 16th, 9 o'clock.
Perfect. Great. 9 o'clock?
Yeah.
Got it.
How are you enjoying this?
My pregnancy?
Yeah. I mean, I'm kind of jealous. What's it like?
Oh, I don't know how to describe it.
It's incredible. It's just incredible.
That's what I figured you were going to say.
Yes, you know, I've heard all these people talk about how they hated it when they gained weight and they have this morning sickness and they get kicked in the bladder and everything. And I thought, ugh, this is going to be horrible, but I love it. I can hardly wait to be kicked in the bladder. It's going to be great, you know? And I don't mind. I'm eating like a pig, so I got a good excuse. You know what?
Hi. I thought you were down for an appointment. Yeah. How did it go?
You tell her.
She's wonderful. Excuse me, though.
Okay, bye.
Congratulations to you and Sean. I'm very happy for you.
Oh, thanks. Oh, Bobby, I missed him so much.
I know you did. But I knew it was going to work out for you, too.
It really has. Actually, everything. Including Lucas, actually.
What about Lucas?
I don't know. I don't know. It's like maybe it's because I'm pregnant. Maybe it's because Sean and I are back together. I don't know. It's like, it just doesn't hurt as much, you know?
Well, I'm delighted that Lucas is going to have a little cousin to play with soon.
I know. Isn't that terrific? I had to get Tony to thank for that. I don't think I've properly thanked you for kind of showing me the mistake I made with Sean.
Hey, you know, we didn't tell you anything that you didn't already know.
Yeah, but you put it in perspective. You know, I wasn't seeing right. I wasn't focusing on it, you know, and it... It took really good friends to do that, especially after everything I put you through, you know what I mean?
That's what friends are for. You know that.
Orderly to receive. I sure do. Orderly to receive.
It's time you joined the real world, Felicia. Accidents happen. Nothing is 100% effective.
Well, fine, then. Why the big wait to find out if you are or if you aren't? How long does a pregnancy test take, Jessica? 5 minutes? Have you seen a doctor?
You expect me to answer these questions?
No, because then you would have to tell me your whole plan, wouldn't you?
Oh, Felicia, get a life. You ready, Sean?
Yeah. You guys coming in?
We'll be along in a minute, Sean. Go ahead. Why don't you guys go ahead?
All right.
Good.
Felicia, what are you doing? What was that with Jessica?
I just had a little talk with her about Sean.
What? Why?
I just wanted her to know that I was on to her.
Felicia, I hate to be the one to break this to you, but Sean is the one responsible for getting himself involved in this mess.
That's not the issue.
What's the issue?
The issue is the way she's handling the situation, and I don't like it, and I wanted to tell her about it.
And do you think it did any good?
I don't know, but I just wanted to tell her. Why? Does that quality in a woman threaten you, Mac?
Would I be hanging out with you if it did?
Are you sure you don't have time to come in?
No, I can't. I gotta go back to the Outback. I got all this work all over my desk.
Oh, well, it was really fun. You have to remind me to come surprise you more often. Actually, I guess you'll have to remind me to phone you first. I was lucky that Holly wasn't there, right?
Victoria. Please, I've asked you not to go into this anymore. Let's just stop it.
No, I know. It's just that, you know, I feel bad. It must be very difficult for her to see you every day.
Right? She doesn't see me every day. I don't go to the Outback much. The place depresses me. I keep wanting to torch it.
Still, I just... I don't know. I feel bad about the way...
Please! Are you through now?
Yes, I'm through now. Are you free later?
Yes, I am. Okay. I'll call you.
Okay.
Get your phone.
Oh.
Get your phone. Get your phone.
Okay, bye.
Goodbye.
Hello? Victoria?
Yes?
Hi, this is Holly. Oh. I was wondering if you're free later, maybe we could meet for a cup of tea.
The other day, you could barely manage to say hello to me, Holly.
Well, this is very important. Would you mind coming to my room?
No, that's fine. What time?
12:30.
Okay, 12:30. I'll see you then. Bye.
Bye.
Hi, you two.
Hi, Steve.
Hi. How'd the hearing go?
Hmm? Well, I can think of better ways to spend my morning, but it went fine.
No surprises?
No. Jessica said she'd call me after the session is over.
Well, that could be a while. You know, Bobby and I are about to go have a quick lunch. Do you want to go with us?
No, thanks. There are some things I have to take care of here, then I want to get back to Audrey.
Bobby told me about what happened at the hotel the other night. How is she?
Not too good. She knows Ryan's in jail. She knows he can't get to her, but it doesn't matter. She's just as frightened now as she was when it first happened.
Can I help you, Steve?
Actually, yes. I was about to ask you and Alan if you might be able to cover for me here at the hospital.
Of course we can. You just take care of Audrey, okay?
Yeah.
Whoa, check this out.
What?
Lab reports. It's a pregnancy test for Jessica Holmes.
Amy.
I wonder who she's sleeping with.
I don't really think that's any of your business.
I'm just doing my job. This is paperwork. Besides, I'm serious. I mean, I've only ever seen her with Ryan and Sean. Well, I saw her with Scotty, but that was a really long time ago.
Amy, give me the lab reports. Keep your theories to yourself.
You know, it still amazes me.
What?
That you actually had the nerve to talk to Jessica.
Is it a good nerve or a bad nerve?
I'm not sure, Felicia, and I'm still not sure what you were trying to accomplish.
I don't think we should talk about it. It's gossip.
This is not gossip.
Yes, I consider this one gossip. I'm going to change the subject. You know what I read in a magazine?
It could be anything.
That women are starting to take up boxing.
So?
Well, I think it sounds interesting.
Felicia, it sounds ridiculous.
Oh, I just thought it's like something maybe I could do that.
You know, I should have said, really? Women boxing? Felicia, you'd be great at that. Why don't you try it? And you would have looked at me like I was crazy and dropped the subject. When am I ever going to learn? But let me try it again, okay? Just one more time. Boxing? Felicia, that's great. You'll be incredible at it. You'll have a blast.
Thanks a lot. I'm going to do it. Would you like to go and be my sparring partner?
Right.
Oh, come on. You experienced my self-defense move. Firsthand, I was pretty good, don't you think?
Felicia, I'm not going to jump into the ring and start duking it out with you. I mean, if you'd like to know, I was a Golden Gloves when I was a kid in Australia.
Whoa. Well, come on. It would be fun. You could wear those little short boxing trunks and those big old gloves. Little hit to the right, little hit to the left. Spanky.
So you're saying that there's going to be some kind of physical contact involved?
Of course. How could we avoid it?
When and where?
I get the feeling that you're doing this for all the wrong reasons.
Well, there's nothing wrong about it, or right. I mean, it's very philosophical, actually. There isn't a wrong or a right answer.
Comfortable.
Did you see anyone out there?
Anyone?
A man.
Where?
Out there in the hallway.
In the hall? No. No. Well, what's going on?
No, and I wanted this whole thing to be so perfect, and then...
Holly, what happened?
Well, it's a long story. It was about 5 or 6 years ago. Do you remember when Roger Gallagher was...
Roger Gallagher? You mean the McKenna theft?
So you have heard of it?
Well, of course. Who hasn't? Oh, but wait, that wasn't the Sutton gang.
It was one contingent of us, yes.
You're kidding. Oh, that was brilliant. Holly, that was brilliant. Tell me everything, but this story deserves wine.
Sure. But you know, I do have wine here.
Oh, yeah, you've got that poison that Paloma sent from San Sebastian. You tried to kill me with last time I was over here.
I'm going to tell Paloma you said that.
Somebody should. So tell me about the McKenna theft.
Well, the tricky part was figuring out which ship the pieces were going to be transported on.
And how did you do that?
By disabling the other two ships in the fleet.
I was on one of those ships.
the Tabura. Did you know that?
No, how would I have known that?
For 5 months, we sat there in the harbor. And then just
in
before
Stockholm.
The McKenna thing, yeah, in Stockholm. And then we couldn't, we were supposed to make a gun run to Liverpool, and we couldn't. We had to go in for repairs.
Because you just couldn't get that instrument panel working properly, could you?
I love this. Can I tell you a secret?
I love secrets.
The pariah bonds.
In England?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, everyone went to jail who was involved with that, didn't they?
Not everyone.
I've got another one.
I can't wait.
That really beautiful diamond necklace that Elizabeth Taylor has that Richard Burton gave her.
I don't know if I want to hear this.
Fake. A good fake. Cubic zirconiums. Very good cubic zirconiums because Elizabeth has a very good eye for diamonds.
Where is the original?
Oh, all over the place. A bit in a ring here, pieces in a necklace there.
You know, someone should ring her up and tell her. But first...
Mm-hmm. Room service. I called and ordered some because I didn't have any food ready.
I'm not hungry for food.
But it's already here.
Well, just leave it in the hall.
Okay, but I might as well. It'll just take a second. Am I decent?
No. That's why I love you.
Does the elevator, does it go out like that all the time?
Yeah, pretty often.
Yeah. Well, you know what they ought to do? They ought to get some runners down there, you know, so that they're ready to just run things up for you. Somebody could make some money
doing
that.
That's a good idea.
Don't you think so?
Well,
I've got a lot of ideas, you know, I'm kind of an idea.
No, I mean, I think that's a really good idea. I'm going to bring that up with my association.
Well, works out, then cut me in for a little piece of the action.
You know, I'm really glad that you made this trip with me. I always hate coming home to an empty apartment all by myself when I've been away for a while.
I know what you mean.
I mean, it's always so quiet, you know, and I start thinking, it's sad, and, well, you know.
Well, I'm glad that you sort of gave me this this shove here to get to New York, and, because, you know, I got to deal with Dominique's place and all
that,
yeah.
Oh, that reminds me, I want to get that picture for you of us standing for the schoolhouse. I'll dig it out for you.
Yeah, I'd like a copy of it.
Scott, it's open.
Then wouldn't you have people staying here? Stay out there. Listen, don't touch anything.
I love this place.
Look, it's already in shock.
Where's the phone?
What, they take that too?
No, 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 I'm gonna go call the police.
No, I don't wanna call the police.
Hi, Princess. Tiffany,
hi.
Yeah?
I haven't seen her.
Well, I guess I'm early.
Do you have a second?
Yeah, sure. What's up?
I had a little talk with Jessica a little while ago about you.
You did what?
Oh, I've got to go fill that order for that man at that table.
No, no, no. Felicia,
you
no.
Felicia. No, I'll fill you
Felicia.
In a minute.
Hey, mate.
Do you know what Felicia meant she talked with Jessica?
She told you, huh?
Only that she talked to her. About what, though?
Look, Felicia just laid into Jessica a little bit about not keeping you on the hook about the pregnancy.
Oh, that's all.
And Jessica told her to mind her own business.
Oh, great. That's just great. I hope that Jessica is not pregnant. And I wish I could wipe out the fact that I ever slept with that woman.
This is Dana King. Sunday, join me and Bill Ritter for some holiday tips, from red, white, and blue fashions to making the perfect picnic basket. Plus, best-selling author John Jakes on Good Morning America Sunday.
Sunday, it was the worst school in New Jersey until Principal Joe Clark turned things around. Morgan Freeman stars in the true story, Lean on Me, the ABC Sunday night movie.